Yo, what's up, nerds? Welcome to another $100 deck tech. Today we're talking about Rowan Scion of War. This deck, motherfucker, this was $100 yesterday. So we'll have to make a cut along the way, but I'll show you the base and you tell me what I do with it. So we're going with Rowan Scion of War. So it's a 3-mana 4/2 menace. You can tap it. Spells you cast this turn that are black or red cost X less to cast, where X the amount of life you lost this turn. So you're going to try and lose life. So we're going to use cards like Blood Celebrant, which you could just activate, and then you name black mana to add one black mana, lose one life, and just keep doing it to reduce your spells cost. Goblin Motivator to give Rowan haste so she can activate her ability immediately. Vindicate a Firestoker, you're going to be casting a lot of spells, and it's going to help you refill your hand. Bloodbraid Marauder is going to help you cascade for, like, Blood Celebrant or Soul Ring or any of the tutors to help you get all, like, you know, win early on. Keen Duelist is going to help you lose life and put another card in your hand. Stormfist Crusader, one life, draw a card. Tavern Swindler, so with a 50-50 shot, every two turns, so first turn, let's say, you lose three life, you lose the flip, you're down three life. Next turn, you lose three life, you win the flip, you're up six life. So you went neutral, but your spells cost three less each turn. So, Gutter Snipe's going to be burned to help finish off games. Rug of Smothering is going to help reduce your spell cost because it's going to make them keep costing less. Wall of Blood is an easy way to pay life. Treasonous Ogre, you're going to pay that life to make your spells cost less, and you'll have red to cast your spells. Grey Merchant of Asphodel, there's a lot of black in this deck, so it's just also going to help you regain life, because you're going to run out eventually. Street Wraith is 2 damage to you to draw a card, because the cycling cost is just pay 2 life. So it's basically a free draw, like Gitaxian Probe. Infernal Sovereign is going to help you keep getting through the deck, keep casting spells, and losing life for Rowan. Magus the Mirror, so that, let's say, you're down to, like, 5 life, and your opponents are about to kill you, and then you go, bam, Magus the Mirror, and then you swap your life totals, and then you just keep going on with your shenanigans. Pontiff Blight, so Extort is going to help you regain life, and you're going to be casting spells anyway. Crick, Son of Yawgmoth, if you can't read it, so you can pay 2 life instead of black pips, so that's another way for you to lose life. Vilas Broker of Blood, whenever you lose life, draw that many cards. This is going to help you really get going and hopefully get up like a storm count or something. Mana Rock wise, we're talking Soul Ring, Arcane Signet, Rakdos Signet, Talisman of Indulgence, that's all you really need. Lightning Greaves is going to be protection, because Rowan's going to be a magnet for removal. Dark Ritual is going to help you storm off and get things out early. Tragic Slips removal. Vendetta. So we're playing some of these wonky removal spells, because, oh, you're losing life equal to that creature's toughness. Well, I pay 1 black, hit a wall, lose 5 life, and all my spells cost 5 less. Abrade is removal. Commune with Lava is going to be you deal 10 damage to yourself with Rowan, exile the top 10. Next turn, you probably win. Blood Pact is going to cost less, make your spells cost less, and then draw you. Chaos Warp is removal. Fire Covenant is removal, and you pay life. Seething Song is going to help you storm off, get things out early. Storm King's Thunder is going to be wild. If you can cast a spell like, well, you cast a spell as many times as you've taken damage, so let's say we have that 3 red pips, right? And we're going to use Treasonous Ogre. So we're going to pay 9 life to get 3 red. That means that the next spell we cast, we copy 9 times with Storm King's Thunder. Little crazy, if you think about it. Big score is, draw, cycle through your deck, whatever, and treasures. Profane Tutor and Gamble are both tutors to get your win cons. Same with Scheming Symmetry. Crackle with Power is going to be your main win con, though. This card in Rowan is nuts.
it basically says for every 3 life you've lost this turn, deals 5 damage. It's absolutely crazy. All right. This is how you're going to be winning games, because you go, "Oh, I have Wall of Blood out. I'm going to pay 15 life." Then you cast Crackle with Power. X is going to equal 5, and then you're just paying red, and that's 25 damage to up to 5 targets. That's absolutely fucking insane. Like, Jesus Christ. And then if you pay more life, it's just going to get bigger. This is absolutely a game winner. Damnable Pact. So, this one kind of hurts yourself, because you probably want to be drawing cards, and it's going to make your spells cost less, but, like, there's Blood Pact, where it's only 2 draw, lose 2 life, and I guess this is kind of similar, but at the same time, you want to be using your spells cost less. So if you lose 10 life with Rowan, and then you use that 10 on Damnable Pact, you've lost 20 life. Sure, you probably have enough spells to win the game now, but sometimes it feels a little sketchy. Exsanguinate is going to be another win con, because, so, there's 3 players in a game, right? And if you're paying life to get the X up for Exsanguinate, right? Let's say you pay 20 life in that turn. So, Exsanguinate, X equals 20, deals 20 damage to each opponent, and then you gain 60. So, this is positive, no matter how you look at it, and it's going to be a great way to stop yourself from losing or finish off games. Feed the Swarm is going to lose you life, which is good, and it's also removal, which is good. Grape Shot is kind of like a... It's kind of a not very good card in this deck. I partially added it because it's cheap, but theoretically you're going to want to be casting a lot of spells, so it could be good. Gyos Immolating Inferno. This is pretty similar to... Well, not pretty similar. It's somewhat similar to Crackler with Power or Exsanguinate. It's not as good, but X damage to up to 3 targets. You pay all but 1 of your life, then cast Jaya's and whatever. So it could turn out pretty well. Night's Whisper loses you life, draws you cards, can help you get through the deck. Rolling Thunder. Dividing the damage isn't great, but it can kind of act like a board wipe if you need that. Sign in Blood, drawing cards, losing life, whatever. Ren's Resolve is card advantage. Parting Thoughts is another one of those weird removal spells, because you're also losing life. But if you think about it, draw X, lose X. So let's say, oh, I kill a 5-5 with it. All my spells cost 5 less, and I've drawn 5 cards. That's pretty much setting you up to go somewhere with your turn. Read the Bones, again, draw, removal, or not, draw, lose life. Tendrils of Agony is similar to Grape Shot. It's probably not always going to be great, but you could theoretically finish games with it, especially if you've lost life, and then you're going, like, Read the Bones is one, Damnable Pact is one, Night's Whisper is one, and you're just going to cycle through your deck. You could theoretically get the Storm Count high, but that's not really what the deck's built to do. Illicit Shipment is usually a bad tutor. However, you're able to search your library for 2 cards if you sacrifice a creature with power 3 or greater. And since its mana cost is probably going to cost less, it's probably just going to set you up to win with Crackle of Power or whatever. Mana Geyser, keep those turns going, go crazy. Brass's Bounty, I usually wouldn't recommend. However, if Roman's going to make your spells cost less, this is kind of like a... Okay, its ability isn't the same as Dockside. Let's say you've got 6 lands, right? You got 6 lands, you have Rowan, you tap Rowan, you've paid 6 life. It's a 1 mana, create 6 treasures. Dockside is usually like a 2 mana, create 6 treasures. So it's gonna help you win, it's gonna help you go off, whatever. Peer into the Abyss is another win con here. So, you usually want to target yourself. You're going to lose half your library. You're going to lose half your life. So, all your spells will cost 20 less. And you've got, like, 40 cards in hand. This card's kind of nuts. Blasphemous Act is a board wipe. in Garruk's Wake is probably the strongest board wipe, and you're definitely going to be able to reduce that 7. So just destroying all creatures and planeswalkers you don't control is very strong. Profane Transfusion is a little wacky, but if you pay your life in order to cast it, and then exchange life totals, so like, you go, oh, I'm going to use, I'm going to use Blood Celebrant. I'm going to pay and pay and pay. I'm going to pay 39 life or whatever, right? And then you go Profane Transfusion, swap with somebody who has, you know, 40 life. They're going to be at 1 life, and you're going to create a 39-39 colorless heart or artifact creature token. Which I think, nope, still just a har. I thought it was a Phyrexian now, but I guess not. Apex of Power is going to be another way to finish games. 7 cards in in hand is a lot. And 10 mana, it's probably just going to win you the game. So Font of Agonies, whenever you pay life, which you're going to be doing a lot, put a blood counter on it. Remove 4 blood counters, destroy target creature. This is really going to help you control the game because you're going to be paying a lot of life. Roiling Vortex seems a little gimmicky, but if you think about it, it just makes all your spells cost 1 less every turn. And your opponents can't gain life is also okay. Necropotence is gonna help you win. You're gonna get a lot of cards in hand. You're paying life to get those cards in hand. Very, very strong. Phyrexian Arena. Again, you're drawing 1 and your spells are gonna cost 1 less. Very strong. Greed. You're paying 2 life, which you want to do anyway, and drawing a card. So there's really no downs. Well, there's the downside of you could possibly lose, but I mean, like, hopefully you draw into what you want before you lose. Mana Barbs is going to help you get really low on your turn, or lose a whole bunch of damage. whatever. Canyon Slows starts off the lands. It's just a basic cycle land. It's all cool. Command Tower, Foreboding Ruins, Mount Doom pays life, so it's going to make your spells cost less. Mountain, Shadow Blood Ridge, Smoldering Marsh, Sulphur Springs is going to deal damage to you. You can have Sunscorched Desert deal damage to you. Desert, Tramway Station, draw a card, and that's it. However, if I had a little bit more budget for this deck, because apparently we're already going over budget, City of Brass would be a great, like, option, because it's also going to help you lose life, and Jessica's Will would be a really nice way to help finish off games. However, I'm pretty confident with the deck how it is. It is a little bit creature light, but I feel like once you get out Rowan, the game's kind of over. So, let me know. Tell me what you think. I gotta figure out where I cut that $1, but I'll see you in the next one.